David Lowery is one of my favorite directors. His films have a very distinct style to them. His films are not for the average moviegoer. In my opinion, his films are art. A review I read of Lowery's latest film, The Green Knight, said his movie felt utterly devoid of joy. I disagree. I'm not sure the average moviegoer can pick up on the intentions Lowery has with his methods. They break the traditional mold of a film. His movies challenge you as you watch them. His techniques are a love language to film. His color choice, the lenses he uses, down to the duration of the shot. Everything you see is intentional and thought out. The first movie I saw by David Lowery was A Ghost Story, a film about a man who dies and becomes a ghost and then watches powerless as time continues on without him. With this film, David Lowery asks you to feel death's cold, unforgiving grasp. He challenges you to feel time. Instead of the quick-paced shots a typical movie would use, Lowery keeps the camera static and unmoving on an image for long lengths of time. He establishes the film early on with these long-duration shots, preparing his audience for what is to come as they embark on this journey. When the man dies, we stare at his sheet-covered body for a minute before he rises. Another long and arduous scene to watch is the grieving wife eating an entire pie on the floor of her kitchen. Lowery is the master of time. Here's some of what Lowery had to say about his usage of time in the film.
A Ghost Story is very much about the passage of time, and so I wanted that passage to exist for the audience. I wanted them to experience that passage of time, for that passage of time to become part of the experience of watching the film itself. And so it just made sense to use long takes. You know, sometimes that movie moves very quickly. You know, towards the end of the film, we move through centuries in, you know, a matter of three or four cuts. But at the beginning, I wanted to really put time front and center, and the passage of time, and all that that entails. And that does involve boredom, that does involve tedium, that does involve the feelings that transpire when you're just sitting still for a long period of time.
In the same way Lowery makes you watch these long takes, he also masters allowing time to slip by quickly. He never tells you, he shows you. The changing of seasons, the simplicity of a different shirt on a character to reveal the passing of days. Lowery slips time through your fingers, yet at the same time, tasks you with paying attention to what some might call a boring film. Even his choice in representing the ghost as a man in a sheet is a thought-out decision. His films have a message that he is driving home to the audience, a theme, if you will. He begs you to watch for his intentional usage of these techniques to pick up on his meaning. It's not just this film either that you see Lowery use these techniques. In his latest film, The Green Knight, they are ripe throughout. His mastery of time creeps up in this film in different ways than A Ghost Story. He uses time here to play with the audience and trick. One moment, the main character, Gawain, can be dead, and then the next, we watch as time spins back to show him making a different choice and altering his fate. Spoiler alert, this foreshadows the end of the film, showing an alternate reality where because Gawain is a coward, he becomes king, but he still succumbs to his fate at the hands of the Green Knight, only for time to flash back and us to watch him make a different choice. This technique usage helps to drive home Lowery's theme with this movie. Bravery and honor. Lowery still uses long takes in this film to drive home a feeling, and to task you with feeling the weight of what a journey like this would entail. The film has many more quick takes than A Ghost Story, but the long take is still featured here. Lowery uses color more abundantly here. Green, red, and yellow. But Lowery used red in A Ghost Story just the same to make his audience feel a certain way. David Lowery's style to his films gives off a distinct feeling of horror and fantastical. Every element to his films are carefully thought out and planned, and I think this is what gives him such a specific feel to his movies. They have a message to spread, and if you can take note of his building block techniques, then you'll pick up on his themes and not be scared off by his films. If you haven't watched one of his films, I challenge you to do so. They aren't for everyone, but if you can appreciate the thought and art that he pours into his work, you may find yourself a fan, just like I am.